Hey Virgo, it's Goddess Puff and welcome to your reading. All right, let's get started with an oracle card message for Virgo. What is going on with my Virgos at this very moment in time? What does Virgo need to know for Virgo? All right, and one more shuffle. All righty, let's see. I hope the camera's not blurry, y'all. I've been trying to wipe it off before I start. All right, we have Raven, determination. Not surprising for y'all at all. B, community. Aw, I feel like you're working really hard towards a goal and you have people surrounding you, rooting for you. Toad, fortune. Yeah, okay, I see you crossing a finish line. People are clapping for you, congratulating you. I see confetti. I see you are the first one to cross the finish line. You're breaking the tape. Your hands are up. I'm seeing, run awareness. And there's someone aware of this? Badge of persecution. I don't know why tonight I just feel like pulling a lot of cards. So it's just what it's gonna be. Overall energy is wolf communication. I don't know why, but I feel like you're unexpectedly gonna be getting calls of celebration. People are gonna be calling you and celebrating. You're gonna get a lot of communication, a lot of people celebrating you, congratulating you for some unexpected goal you reach. You don't see this coming at all. This is a total surprise for you. Even though you've been working really hard, out of nowhere, it's just like this big like goal you reach, or congratulations or something like that. All your friends and family and people who are supporting you are congratulating you, or they're planning this surprise, because I feel like they figure it out before you do. Because I feel like you've been working so hard that you don't even realize that you crossed the finish line. When you do, you don't even realize it. So people are congratulating you before you even realize you've done it. They're making you aware that you did it, which is crazy. I feel like by the time you realize, you didn't already win a few more miles past the finish line. Yeah, with determination, because you're so focused. You got so much tunnel vision on what you're doing. And it's like you have people around you cheering you on, because the center of this reading is already Toad, fortune. So whatever goal you're trying to reach, you are going to reach it and then some. And with awareness, I feel like it's badger persecution. Of course, there's always a hater or someone lurking in the bushes waiting to get upset with you or to persecute you for reaching your goal. Weird, but I digress. Let's get into the tarot for Virgo. A message for Virgo. What does Virgo need to know at this very moment in time for Virgo? We're gonna see how the oracle card message ties into your reading for Virgo. Alrighty. Okay, we have the Hermit card. Of course, the first card out is your card, Virgo. You are 1,100% in your energy. We love it. Going right over Raven, determination. Let me move this out of the way. So you're 100% in your energy. You're just, like I said, the Hermit card is all about trusting yourself, your inner wisdom, inner guidance, grounding. You're like tunnel vision, focused on you. So you're in the house or just in your office, just work, work, work. The Star card, Aquarius, this is very healing for you. So working is very healing. I also feel like, of course, you're healing and working on yourself, bringing yourself back into your energy. So right now, if you've been looking for some type of healing or grounding, or what you need to do is go into Hermit mode and just ask yourself, listen to yourself. You have all the answers. I feel like going into Hermit mode temporarily is healing for you. We have the King of Swords, okay? Could be an air sign involved, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, especially with the Star card, Queen of Cups, Water, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Ace of Wands, the Emperor, Aries, and the Devil, Capricorn. So I'm seeing you as definitely the Emperor and the Devil here, like just working really hard. I don't know if you have your own business or you're just a really hard worker. Overall, I'm just the Eight of Cups walking away. So I feel like you could be working from home instead of in the office. You get more work done at home or just within your own closed space. It's very healing for you to focus on work and yourself and to work alone. I feel like that'll be very healing for you. Because I feel like there's a, right here with this King of Swords, I feel like, I don't know if you've become very cold or distant, but I feel like it'll be very healing for you to go within with the Queen of Cups. Because I feel like there's, of course, an Aquarius here with the star, but there's a water sign here as well. That could be another aspect of you. But I feel like there's someone coming towards you with this fiery, creative energy. It could be an Aries. We have the Devil here as well with Capricorn. But I feel like these are you. But I feel like there's an Aries being made aware of you. But there's someone here who's with Badge of Persecution and the Devil. It's like someone wants to persecute you, or they're mad at you, or obsessing over how you're keeping to yourself. Or the more you go into yourself, or the more you heal yourself and focus on you, the more this person wants to, like, persecute you, for lack of a better way of saying it. It could be this water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. But I just feel like, I don't see that you're doing anything wrong, though. I feel like you're just focused on yourself and healing. And then you have someone here who wants to, it's like, you go within and you heal. And it's like the moment you win, someone wants to persecute you for that. So say, for instance, you've been losing or struggling or suffering in any way, shape, or form. This person didn't do anything, but it's the moment you win, they attack you. It's just, it's confusing to me because someone wants to attack you for winning, or attack you for healing, or attack you for focusing on your goals. It doesn't make any sense. Let me clarify, because it's not making any sense to me. Clarify this for Virgo. All right. Clarify this for. Okay, let's see. Clarifying the Hermit card is the King of Pentacles. Yeah, there you are. Of course, you could be dealing with a Capricorn or have it highly aspected in your chart. Ten of Cups. Okay. So, there's a Capricorn who clearly, or this could be another aspect of you, but I feel like there's a Capricorn who is in love with you, or someone who has Capricorn highly aspected in their chart. They're obsessed with you. Or they want to start a family with you. They see you as the one. Yeah, there's an Emperor, Aries, matriarch of the family. There's a boss in the background who's watching you, and they see you as the perfect fit. Now, I'm seeing it as love, but put it where it goes for you, it could be work. But because of your work and because of your healing, this person sees you as the perfect fit for them. I also feel like you could just be working hard for your family, of course, but I am seeing that someone has their eye on you. Clarifying the stars, the Wheel of Fortune, Aquarius, Scorpio, Aquarius, Scorpio, Leo, Taurus. Yeah, your healing is turning the wheel for you. I feel like you are doing something major, some major inner work, as well as, of course, physical, because I feel like you are working extremely hard. You are just, you could be working right now while listening to this reading. But it's like, you're also cranking out healing at the same time. Somehow, some way, your work is very healing for you, and healing leads you to work. They're both intertwined. Yeah, Five of Wands. Okay, so there's someone who's trying to compete with you. What's weird is someone's trying to, like, compete with you for the spotlight. And it's crazy because you don't even want it. You're in hiding. With the Hermit card, you don't even want it. But for some reason, you're getting the spotlight anyway. You don't even want the spotlight. You want to be left alone. Also, someone's trying to make healing a competition, which is ridiculous. Either way, you're not, you're absent from this. You're so focused on you that you don't even see this. You're so absent from it. It's like someone wants to compete with you with the Five of Wands. Like, oh, I've healed first, or I'm getting attention first, or whatever. Someone wants to beat you, and it's weird. With the Wheel of Fortune clarified by the star, I feel like you've healed and you've changed your karma. or you're healing, you're focused on your healing instead of you're healing conflict within yourself or between you and someone else, whether they want to heal it or not, you're healed. You've made peace with it. Yeah, the Five of Wands clarifying the Star. You've made peace with it within yourself. And you've created good karma. You've put yourself on the right side of the wheel. Because regardless of if someone wants to compete with you or not, they're beefing on their own. You're just healed. That's why you're getting all these blessings. That's why the wheel is turning for you. Or it's turning right now, even if you haven't seen it come to fruition. Because you're just healed. Yeah, I just don't see any spite for you. I just see nothing but good karma. Clarifying the King of Swords is the Knight of Swords. Then we have this like win at all costs type of energy here with the Queen of Cups. So there's a water sign and an air sign. Let me clarify. Clarifying the Queen of Cups is the Knight of Wands. Wow. Okay. Seven of Wands. Okay, so there's an air sign trying to win at all costs with a water sign, or a water sign trying to win at all costs with an air sign. I feel like, there's conflict between you and an air sign or someone who has air highly aspected in their chart. I feel like they're karmic, or they're trying to like force fate or whatever. But I feel like with the Queen of Cups, I feel like they're telling you to take a mature approach with this and stand your ground or stand up for yourself and focus your energy on work. Because I feel like there's an air sign trying to force their hand or force their way or compete with you or combat you or argue with you or whatever this is. Because with the Star card here and this King of Swords here, there's clearly an air sign trying to argue with you, or an air sign arguing with a water sign. Because I feel like the water sign is trying to sleep with, because we have the Knight of Wands here, or they're fighting off this person. I don't know what this has to do with you besides this air sign trying to argue with you, and you've healed that. It's like they're trying to compete with karma. Like the wheel is turning regardless, right? Good karma, the wheel is turning. If you are having bad luck or bad karma, it's turning for you. You're healing, right? But it's like someone wants to combat that or compete with that. And I feel like it's a water sign trying to interfere. It's like a water sign is trying to win at all costs with this air sign. I don't know what this has to do with you though. I feel like the water sign may want to compete with you for this air sign. Because it feels like the issue between this water sign and air sign is between them. Got nothing to do with you. What I will say is, like, this air sign maybe trying to, or this fire sign, because there's a lot of wands here, maybe trying to like sleep with you or sleep with this water sign. This water sign standing their ground like no. So because they didn't get what they want, now they want to combat, and it's just not working. But I feel like you're going to be working with this Capricorn anyway, or this Aries anyway. So this situation has nothing to do with you. I don't know what this air sign and water sign got going on, but that has nothing to do with you. Clarifying the Ace of Wands is the Four of Wands. Yeah, you're going somewhere else with the fire sign. Aries, Ace of Wands. Wow. So yeah, the Ace of Wands, clarifying the Ace of Wands, the Four of Wands. Clarifying the Emperor is the Page of Swords. Yeah, there's an Aries watching this situation play out. The High Priestess. Clarifying the Devil is the Two of Wands and the Eight of Cups. Yeah, you're walking away from something toxic. Overall energy is the Tower. Aries. Wow, yeah. So this is pretty straightforward. You're dealing with a very toxic person. It could be a Capricorn. Put it where it goes for you. And there's an Aries who sees this. They're providing you with, or they want to provide you with, a new stable job or home. And so that you can walk away, there's an Aries about to reach out to you so that you can leave this situation. Because I feel like you're dealing with someone extremely toxic and combative, or you live around people who are just toxic and combative. Because I feel like there's an air sign and a water sign just going back and forth, and it's a lot going on around you. And I feel like you've removed yourself from the situation, or you want to. I see you walking away, you're done. And there is an Aries who allows you the opportunity to do so with the Tower, the Eight of Cups. Because it's just, I feel like also with the Eight of Cups and the Two of Wands clarifying the Devil, someone's going to try to make it hard for you to go. Or to persecute you for walking away. And there's also an Aries, Emperor, or father figure, controlling individual who's buying readings on you or spying on you with the Page of Swords and the High Priestess. Yeah, with Ren Awareness. There's just a controlling person in the background spying on you, keeping tabs on you, watching your every move through readings. And you're going to be made aware of that. Because I'm seeing like you've healed conflict. You're not competing. You're not, because the Five of Wands is clearly clarifying the Star, healing. And then the Wheel of Fortune, the karmic wheel is turning. So you're good. Your situation's good. But then we have this air energy trying to win at all costs with this water sign and vice versa with this player type of energy. So I feel like there's an Aries trying to come in and like force a situation, or water sign trying to infiltrate a situation. Because I feel like there's a fire sign, Aries, trying to come in and seduce you. And then there's this water sign trying to come in. And it's just a lot of people trying to get involved in this. All of this is just toxic as hell. I feel like you've healed a conflict. And then here come all these people trying to interfere. There's an Aries spying on all this. There's a Capricorn, someone extremely toxic here. And we got this water sign. Stand your ground against any, like, this is just too much, Virgo. I'm sorry you're dealing with all this. Yeah, the Tower. Regardless of all this BS, you're about to get word of a stable foundation, a strong foundation, a place for you to thrive. Your business is going well. You have support. I just feel like you're getting word of, with Ren Awareness, you're being made aware that someone in the background has been spying on you and like trying to get back at you and compete with you. You're getting word of this. Someone around you is determined to like force this wheel, this karmic wheel. I'm gonna leave it there. I send you peace, blessings, and love. Namaste.